going to Nottingham for the playoff finals weekend. This is a time for Dundonian heroes, and we reach for the stars.
We've got tickets for Sunday's game.
The season has come down to one game, and one game only, and that is this one right here, live from the Dundee Ice Arena. A slender one-goal lead halfway through this game for the Dundee Stars, and the Sheffield Steelers will, I'm sure, come out the gates all guns blazing and press for an equaliser early doors, put the Stars under significant pressure early in this game.
The whistle comes again to stop.
puck is dropped on the second leg of the Premier Sports Elite League playoff quarter final. Ben is intercepted in huge pace here, goes in 1-on-1 and goes top shelf. What a goal that is from Martin Little. Pulls a goal back on the power play for the Stars. 2:09 left in the second period. And this building has just had the roof come off. Score in the second leg. Dundee 1, Sheffield 3. And an aggregate Dundee 2, Sheffield 3. We'll have a one goal game. And it's game on.
That's Sheffield, number 19. 2-1-2 for Hastings. And that's the 7-20. We're in the Stars.
Only past for Saunch. Saunch will take this up the right hand side. Let's play for Combs. Combs switching it across to the other side. For Desjardins. Desjardins out to the blue line. Back in down low for Desjardins. Desjardins went for Combs. Combs for Bengtsson. Bengtsson shoots one. Scores! Sebastian Bengtsson. Who else? Busts the back of the net with that one. With 1:05 left in this game. And all of a sudden, the Stars are equal on the night and in front in this quarter-final. As it stands, the Stars are going to the playoff finals weekend. There's still 1:05 remaining though. And this is going to be a long 1:05. Sebastian Bengtsson's second goal of the evening, his third of the weekend.
This is the time for Dundonian Heroes, and he reaps for the stars.
Yeah. Well, Omar, what does this mean to you tonight? Unbelievable, isn't it?
It's unbelievable. The guys, their effort tonight was second to none. So proud of them. The work rate tonight, guys going down, them stepping up. They have nothing left in the tank, but so proud of this group. They work so hard. They really do, and they're so committed. So really proud of them.
When Steelers took the lead that they did you see a way back at that point?
You know what? It was a tough start, but I thought we just fought too much. We just fought too much this year to settle and to stop. But you know, that's our character. You know, adversity we thrive on it, and we stepped up. A big goal by Calvis, 5-on-3, and then third period I thought the boys found a way, and so proud of them.
And you've said for many, many months that this team has got the ability to do this. They've got the ability to be the best that they can be. They certainly have shown you that tonight, and that must give you great confidence going into next weekend.
Yeah, huge confidence. You know, it's a great night. I'm sure the guys will enjoy it. I got Daddy doing this again. But I'm so proud of them. But saying that, we got a big game on Saturday against, I think, Belfast now, so it'll be a huge challenge, but we've had success. So the guys will refocus, enjoy tonight, but refocus for next week because, you know, there's only one game from a final. So.
Omar, we talked about you, the players. Are these fans behind you and all around here tonight absolutely incredible?
Yeah, there's no words. Look at it. I mean, it's the best feeling I've ever had. I'm sure the players can say the same. So the support has been fantastic tonight. I mean, they were the reason why we won. They kept pushing on our guys. So, you know, I really appreciate it.
Omar, go and enjoy yourself. Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
You're a legend, man. Legend.
I'm the best right now.
Hold up. Never been proud of a group. You guys, this tonight was unbelievable. That third period, man, I got goosebumps. And the way you battled, the way you competed, you guys were tired, but you kept finding a way. You were so committed, boys. This, you deserve this. You deserve it. You had a lot of downs, but tonight you outworked them. Yesterday you outworked them, boys. Sebi, way to step up. Team performance to say the least, boys. I'm so proud of you guys. We'll get enjoy tonight, boys. But we're going there with a purpose, oh, yeah. Right? We're going there with a purpose. So, boys, congratulations. You're the first Dundee Stars team to clinch a playoff spot in the Final Four at home. So that's a great achievement. And you did it against the Sheffield Steelers. So that's even better. Oh, yeah. Holy boys.
Yeah, we'll get paid enough.
What an emotional roller coaster that game, but we stuck through it. We get to extend our stay a little bit. Mo, hell of a job, but the sexy sweet.
Come on, guys! Two games to go! Then your history, your no history, will make history for this club. Well done, everybody.
He's got his strong beliefs. More and more people just want more.
mom sent me a text message that she was almost crying at the end of the game. She was so emotionally involved. So it's exciting. And, you know, I'm so happy for this group and this organization to move on to the Final Four. It's fun.
We knew there's always a chance, and we just got to keep pushing hard. And we're in front of our home crowd, so we got to push it. We had to push all the way, and we're happy to get that result.
Did you go to Belfast? Going to play Belfast in the next round now. How special is that going to be?
Oh, that's going to be a lot of fun too. We've played them a few times, and we know we can compete against them. So we're ready for another big challenge.
That Final Four weekend in Nottingham. You've never been there yourself, but just how much are you looking forward to that game?
It's going
to
be fun. It's a different format. It's a one game move on. So we know we can beat everyone in this league. So we just got to show up, play our game, and you know we're confident in this group and the way we play that we can beat anyone. So it's good.
Right, Quinn, we'll start with that then. You've been on the bench 2-0. How did that feel?
Oh, it feels fantastic. I'm basically just there to provide some positivity and you know, cheer on the guys just in a glorified way, I guess. I get to be on the bench right now, so it's great.
You know, like you say, there's ups and downs. I think it just makes it more special, you know. It shows the character we have in this room, that everybody's stuck together regardless of the outcome. Every single night, every single weekend, we believed in each other and knew we could get a job done.
From the day I walked into the room, you know, it was chatter the whole time, and it made it really easy to transition into this group and great group of guys, and there's not a better team to make it to the Final Four right now.
Yeah, it feels amazing. I mean, couldn't be prouder of the group. Down 3-0, coming back 4-3, it's probably one of the craziest games I've been a part of.
Honestly, I'm speechless. It was awesome. It was unreal. The boys, you know, compete hard all season. Obviously, we had a hard start of the season, but the guys stick with it, and we finished really strong, and obviously, to come on top of Sheffield, it's unreal. You know, I'm speechless. Guys worked their butt off, and it paid off.
No, it was huge. I think the Dundee fans were louder last night, so we definitely had a chance to feed off of them, and yeah, we made a mark there, and then we continued on to here, and we won, so...
Charlie, come in on the interview.
Yeah.
Come on,
the
two of you together.
Yeah, we continued it, and now we're going to the Final Four, so let's go.
And now we're going to Nottingham.
Yeah.
I didn't hear the question.
Yeah, I mean, that was amazing. The crowd's been there for us all season long, and to see that rink full like that tonight and for us to finish the game off the way we did was something I'll never forget. And for me, watching tonight, it was pretty – my heart was racing the whole time, and like I said, just super proud of the guys for not giving up and for coming back like they did and to continue our season now.
Yeah, the energy in the whole stadium was, you know, was wild. It's what kept us going. We were battling for sure. We had a long day, and, you know, just looking out and hearing them, it was insane.
He's definitely a guy that feeds off the crowd, and the crowd got him going today. And how many points did you end up with?
Just as much as you, buddy, right?
Well, yeah, I got a couple points today.
Oh, big Kyle, eh? Yeah.
It's nice. Hey, he gave me a couple points today, so...
Look at this thing, eh? He's got extra barrel.
Exactly. No, the last time I think we made it, it was my first year involved with the team. So to actually play a part this year and, you know, help us clinch that spot feels amazing. Brilliant performance from everyone. Great team effort. There's a couple of jokers here, eh? Jesus.
It's Kyle Haas here. You know, like two Dundee guys, how does it feel that you guys are the only Scottish team to go to the Final Four?
I wish I could swear right now, but you're absolutely right. Our best team in Scotland right now. William Wallace would be proud, wouldn't he, Kyle?
What's his saying? Just to remind the crowd here.
Freedom!
Back to Swanee.
I think when I was first here, we were, you know, under 1,000 people a game. This year's been exceptional. The crowd, it's amazing, especially after COVID. I mean, times are tough money-wise for a lot of people as well, but people are digging deep and supporting us, which is massive. Guys obviously really appreciate it. And tonight, like you said, there's 2,000 people here. We get that goal and, you know, you're struggling at the end. Guys are tired, legs are going. But when you've got that crowd behind you cheering you on, we got one, we got two, we got three, and that fourth one just rolled in, give us a little bit of security. But yeah, I mean, huge thanks, I guess, from everyone to the crowd and everyone that comes week in and week out. It's massive, so thank you.
You know, we're playing Belfast, beat all the teams in the league this year, especially the big guns. I suppose you guys won't be fearing them or just making up the numbers?
No, not at all. Give me that. No, but...
That's magic.
Come on, the two of you.
Bars open.
Come on, Spike.
Right, ready? Right, Kev, I'm going to start with you.
Yeah.
You believed all week. I spoke to you during the week. You knew that this could happen with these guys. How happy are
you? Over the moon, guys. I knew these guys would do it.
We spoke to you last time, right?
Yeah.
And you just kept on saying very good. Okay, so how does this feel?
Very good.
I like it.
Well done, son. A wee bit more.
Nah, right, let's be honest, because you've improved on your interviews since then, right? You were there the last time, but how special is this weekend?
Yeah, it's more special this weekend. The whole boys have battled all year.
Yeah, no, they've been great all season. This year especially, I think we've had more sellouts than ever before. So, yeah, no, they've been incredible for us all season. Just to get that reward for them and have that experience. I was getting shivers on the ice. Like, it was incredible. So yeah, they deserve all of that. And, yeah, we're excited. Hopefully a bunch of them can make it down to Nottingham and cheer us on there. So,
for this weekend? Well, before the weekend, I might get a first. Yeah, you know what I mean? Because you could maybe a couple of drinks, eh? Because I put up quite a lot with these guys.
Yeah. Come in on this, actually. What is it like, actually, as we're in the middle, right? What is it like as a guy coming in here, one of our import players, and you have to try and learn the language of these guys? How tough is it?
Yeah, I really don't know what he's saying most of the time, but Chris is pretty good. He's pretty easy. But this guy, I don't know what he's saying half the time. Oh, that's the only thing I can get out of him.
Meow. Yeah. You're good at that, aren't you?
No, don't you? The fish is going to Nottingham.
Now, of course, your dad, massive affiliation with this club. How excited to see you in a Final Four weekend next week?
Yeah, he'll be buzzing along with the rest of the family. They're all supportive. They all love it. So they all love this club as well. So they're happy that I'm playing here, and they're happy for the team and myself that we've got to the Final Four. Yeah.
Well, how big of a part are these guys to the team? Linda, Early, how much are they a part of everything that's happened this week?
They're the best. I mean, they're obviously the reason that we're able to kind of perform the way we perform. I mean, these two work tremendously, and they work so hard at everything they do, and Air Elite too. I mean, you saw her in the third period. She didn't sit still. There, she was walking up and down, and so were they. It couldn't be more happy to do it for them too. It's crazy.
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. I've got no voice left from all the shouting I've been doing. That's up there with the best moments I've ever had playing hockey. That was unbelievable. Like, the boys were down in the third period, it looked pretty grim, but they just pulled back and showed what sort of boys we have in this room. You know, the character, the grit they showed was unbelievable.
I mean, what we saw this weekend, we got a lot more to give, and we're going to Nottingham with a purpose over there, for sure.
You sure are, with Chris Ingles doing moonwalks behind you.
Oh yeah, he's really good at it too.
Oh, unbelievable. Coming from Sheffield, 1-0 to us, we're down 3-0 here. Probably nobody believed in us, so unbelievable, just amazing feeling.
Worked with Charlie Combs.
Yeah, what's it like?
I don't work with Charlie Combs.
And you'll be hating how I'm asking you so many questions right now, because you hate interviews.
Yeah, I do hate interviews.
What's your favorite shot to, favorite spot to shoot?
You know it, Charlie. In the net.
Bottom left.
No, in the net.
But yeah, listen, Seb, thanks very much for everything, and best of luck next weekend. It's going to be a huge one.
Yeah, thank you so much, and thank you for all the support. It's been amazing.
Who's your favourite sports therapist in the AHL?
Oh, definitely the person from Sheffield. No, I'm joking. I'm kidding.
What just happened there?
That's you, really.
It's me.
It is.
I think it's very vital to rock around this right on time. It's tricky, it's the time. Here we go.
It's tricky to rock around this right on time. It's tricky.
It's tricky.
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 It's being to rock around, that's right on time, it's tricky. Tricky.
Tricky.
I met this little girlie, her hair was kinda curly. Went to her house and bust her out, I had to leave her early. These girls are really sleazy, all they just say is please me.
Spend some time and bust a rhyme, I said it's not that easy.
3, 2, rock. All right, we're done with this.
I think that's one of the best evenings ever in the 20 years I've watched hockey here. It's an incredible result, it's an incredible comeback from an incredible team actually. There's very few teams in this league could go 3 goals down against a side of that strength and win in normal time. It's just quite incredible. Pretty tearful for a lot of people tonight. I mean, that meant an awful lot.